Hello friends, today I will show you how to use the PicoBT tester to test the Antminer S17E hash board. Attention, when testing the S17E hash board, we need to use a DC 12V PSU to power the PicoBT tester, then use an adjustable voltage PSU to power the hash board, and adjust the output voltage of the adjustable PSU to 17V. Next, connect the 18-pin cable of the hash board. Connect the positive and negative cables of the adjustable voltage PSU to the positive and negative copper sheets of the hash board. When we are ready, start testing the S17E hash board. Press the blue button to select the hash board model S17E. Then press the white button to enter the test interface. This is the PIC switch button. If you choose PC0, the RST signal stays low level at 0V in the hash board. If you choose PC1, the RST signal stays high level at 1.8V in the hash board. Usually we choose PIC mode. This key selects the number of tests. If you choose 1, the test fixture will only test once. If you choose 999, the test fixture will repeat the test continuously, which is beneficial for us to test the relevant voltages. The green button above can select the test mode. MOD mode can test ASIC chip. MD2 mode can test temperature sensing circuit. MD3 mode can test domain voltage. This is the PSU confirmation button. When we use the integrated PSU of the miner to power the hash board, we need to press this button and connect the voltage regulation cable. Because we are using a voltage regulated PSU to power the hash board, there is no need to use this button. Now we start to demonstrate the test methods of the three modes. First, select the mod mode and press the white test button. Look, 135 is displayed here, indicating that the fixture has found 135 ASIC chips. Then select MD2 mode and press the white test button. This shows the number and temperature data of the ASIC chip corresponding to the temperature sensor chip. The first column is the code of the ASIC chip, the second column is the temperature of the temperature sensing chip, and the third column is the temperature of the ASIC chip. Finally, select the MD3 mode and press the white test button. What is displayed here is the voltage value of each domain. This is for the first domain, the second domain, and so on. Well, let me show you how to test the RI signal of the hash board. To test the RI signal, we need to select the 999 test mode. Connect the cable to the fixture and test the RI signal of which domain. Clamp the negative clip of the oscilloscope probe on the corresponding heat sink and connect the probe to the RI test point. Now start testing the RI signal. The oscilloscope probe is placed on the RI test point and the clip is placed on the corresponding heat sink. The number on the right side screen of the tester changes to 36. Which means that it is normal for the RI signal to pass back from the 135th chip to the 100th chip. If the number shows 7, we need to test backwards according to the transmission direction of the RI signal, until we find the chip with abnormal RI signal. Well, the above is the method of testing the Antminer S17E hash board with the PicoBT universal test fixture. See you in the next video.